Greetings, Bait, from 1943, is a funny cartoon, but the story behind the cartoon and what it caused may be funnier. After Bait was nominated for an Oscar, Leon Schlesinger, who never really paid attention to the actual cartoons being made in his studio, ordered his staff to not use the ripple glass underwater effect in any more cartoons since it was too expensive. So, just to annoy Schlesinger, Frizz Freleng included an underwater gag in his excellent Duck Soup to Nuts the following year, and Bob Clampett made practically the entirety of his hair ribbon take place underwater just to piss Leon off. Greetings, Bait is an odd cartoon, largely because Frizz Freleng felt the need to resurrect the Jerry Colonna worm in the first place, but I still like it, and I think it's a gorgeous cartoon in any case, largely because of its backgrounds. But it's also got some nice animation in it, and my favorite scenes in the cartoon are by Dick, Bick, Bickenback. Bickenback's Freeling animation is fairly easy to spot as well as being funny, and his Frank Tashlin stuff is even funnier. Close friends of mine who know my love for early Hanna-Barbera cartoons will know that another reason I love Bick is because he did a lot of excellent design work on the early HB TV Toons, being one of the many wonderful people that helped make the early Hanna-Barbera cartoons some of the most gorgeous cartoons of all time. As we've said before on this show, Freeling's cartoons, at least before guys like Art Davis came into the picture, are fairly tame when it comes to the animation in them. Not all good animation is crazy, though, and not all crazy animation is good. So Freeling's cartoons are pretty solid any way you look at them, and that's why I love them.
Thanks for watching today, folks. We'll be back Friday night as per usual, so I'll see you guys then.